it matters. There are various purposes of the review. Once again, it's the art film, commercial film dichotomy as what is the right and what is wrong. Nothing is right and nothing is wrong. The review, as far as art form is concerned, has to be constructive and cruel. Because you'll have to really tell someone that you have to live with this disease. You're going to die of it. And that's a doctor's job. And that's how cruel a critic will have to get sometime. But even there, it is an attempt to save the patient. Yeah. It shouldn't be simply cruel. It shouldn't be a gladiatorial arena, the Circus Maximus, where you just see gore and blood. And the only what do you call pleasure you take back is you're intellectually superior to the filmmaker and probably the review reader also. That's arrogance. That kind of review I never can. I wrote some like that, so I realized that it's very easy to nickname your teachers. I did in school, and I've written some nasty reviews when I was a fledgling actor. But that is only to show off that I know something about films. Ultimately, there is a purpose to reviewing. It's one, you put an undeniably correct perspective of what should be to the filmmaker itself and to the audience itself. You sort of tell them what is, it's like teaching etiquette to, there is a science to this cinema and there is a language of cinema where you'll have to teach it to the audience, film appreciation. So what is good, once they appreciate it, they'll understand. See, if you take cricket to America, they won't know where to applaud because they don't know what is achievement and what is not. They just see people and ball being, and somebody catches the ball mid-flight. But why and what is more difficult, what is more complicated? You'll have to set the rules of the game, and the critics can do that.